eternally left here without you, without you. And it hurts for me to think about what life could possibly be like without you, without you. I can't believe that you would up and leave me. Call it your reason, I lost my, you know I didn't mean. And now I see it, you run and repeat it. And I can't take it back, so in the past is where we'll leave it. So there you go, oh, can't make a wife out of a, oh. I'll never find the words to say I'm sorry, but I'm scared to be alone. You cut out a piece of me and now I bleed. Internally left here without you, without you. And it hurts for me to think about what life could possibly be like without you, without you. Oh, oh. Even harder to let you go. I really wish that we could have got this right. So there you go. Oh, can't make a wife out of a. Oh, I'll never find the words to say I'm sorry, but I'm scared to be alone. You cut out a piece of me, and now I bleed internally. Left here without you, without you. And it hurts for me to think about what life could possibly without you, without you. Oh, oh, why, oh, oh, why, oh, oh, why, oh, oh, why, without you, without you.
So without you, I remember I was at my old house in my home studio, and I was going through some with a girl and a couple of girls, and my friend Oma came through with his guitar, and I told him, I was like, because I'd been listening to a lot of Sia, and I was like, play something that you think Sia would sing over, and that's what he ended up playing. And then he did that, and I just got on the mic and just started going from there. In the past is where we'll leave it. When I work, like, I like collaboration. Like, I like hearing other people's ideas. There's a lot of artists that go into making music and like, haha, I write and do all of this all of myself, haha, f*** you guys. Like, and it's like, dude, shut the f*** up. Cause like, at the end of the day, for me at least, my thing is like, I wanna get the best music possible, and I want to get like, I want to be able to communicate my emotions fully. And sometimes people have good ideas, man. Like, you shouldn't be scared of that. Like, it's making music at the end of the day. Don't think about it too hard, just do it. And if it sounds good, it sounds good. If it feels good, it feels good. If you're comfortable with it, then go crazy, you know. But that's me. That's how I approach music anyway. Just with all my music, I just wanted to be able to help people, and first and foremost, tell people you're not alone, but second of all, make them happy. And just, you know, I don't know, that's the goal for me with my music, is getting my feelings out, and then like, yeah, hopefully other people connect with it and other people can relate and feel good about themselves, you know? You know what's crazy? From the beginning, when I made that song, and we were putting the project, the little deluxe together, I was like, this is the best song. Obviously, I didn't think it was gonna be as big as it was, but I knew that was the best song on the tape. I knew it was the best one. Like, I felt the most out of that one. You know, I felt that one the most out of all the ones. I was like, damn, like, you could feel this one, so. Oh, oh, without you, without you.
times when I ain't at. No food in my crib, now I live lavish. They say they love me to my face, but they can't stand it. Them they fuck with me back then, now they attracted. And Tash and my bro, he gon'. Don't tell me what I've been through, you don't know. Made it out the mud, without you. I'm good, I did this for my bro. Just to show him one day you could. I did this for my mama, cause I told her one day I would. My life been tragic, thank you for asking. I seen too many of my fam end up in caskets. I seen too many of my friends turn into ashes. Wish I still had them. Light up, put it to the sky, I'm trying to get. Look me in my eye, tell me it's up. Had it cut, plenty people love. Money on my, I can't with them. I can't trust nobody but I. No food in my crib, now I live lavish. They say they love me to my face, but I can't stand it. Them, they fuck with me back then, now they attracted. Attached to my bro ego. Don't tell me what I've been through, you don't know. Made it out the mud, without you. I'm good at this for my little bro. Just to show him one day you could. I did this for my mama, cause I told her one day I would. Oh yeah, I remember times when I ain't at. No food in my crib, now I live lavish.
So Tragic, I believe, I was in a session with Internet Money, Taz, Cody, and all them, and we were in there, and they played that beat, and I told them, oh, can we strip off the drums, and let me just record on the piano, and just maybe like a hi-hat or something, I think I just started freestyling like that. It didn't have the hook part yet. It didn't have the don't tell me what I've been through, you don't. It didn't have that part yet. I just left it how it was and did a verse, and it was just an open space. And they put the beat to it and it sounded sick. I went home with it and I was just like, I was sitting with it for like a month or two. One day I was doing another session with Internet Money. We cook together all the time. Doing another session with them, and I was trying to make all these new songs, and I was like, oh, I don't know if I'm in the vibe like to make all of this now. So I told them, I was like, hey, pull up that one idea though, that Tragic. They're like, all right, bet. And then I just did the hook and I sent it to my boy Bibby, who I'm signed to. Yeah, I was like, hey, what do you think of this? I think it's kind of sick. And he's like, yo, this is sick. He said, I remember the text, he said, I'd come out of retirement to get on this song. I definitely look to real life experiences to write that song, not just that song, every song I write. But I mean, again, the song is there for people to interpret it however they want to interpret it and relate it to their lives however they want to relate it. But in my case, I was just saying, like, man, this is my life, and I'm the only person who's lived my life, so don't tell me what the f- is, and don't tell me how I should feel, or don't tell me how I should think, because you don't know what I've been through to think or feel like this. So, yeah. Money on my, I can't quit them, I can't trust nobody but I. After I made that song, I was just like, oh, like it's like a stress was weighed off me, and I was like, I'm putting this out for the people, and I think they'll with it. So, yeah. What I've been through, you don't know. Made it out the mud, without you. I'm good at this for my little bro. Just to show him one day you could. I did this for my mama, cause I told her one day I would. Yo, what's up, MTV? I'm the Kid LAROI, and I'm about to push play. I have two songs that remind me of my childhood. The first one is Heartless by Kanye West. And the second one is 25 to Life by Eminem. I don't know exactly why, just whenever I hear both of those songs now, it just takes me back like to the time when like that came out, and like just like different memories of like me and my mom and my uncle who's now passed away, and just like other stuff like that. I don't know, it's crazy. Like music, it can have different memories and different meanings for like all different type of people. So like I hear like Heartless by Kanye West and it takes me back to the time, and like my friend can hear that song and it takes him back to a completely different time in their life, you know, so. whatever's hot at the moment, whatever's the hot at that moment, if I'm in the car with my friends. I was just talking to my friend about this the other day. He was like, hey man, I ain't gonna lie, I'm gonna have to grab the aux cord from you when we all get in the car. And I was like, please take that. I was like, because when I'm on the aux cord in the car, I'll play a whole bunch of like weird and obscure that no one's like ever heard of in life. And like everyone would be like, what is this? So like, I hate like being on the aux when there's like everyone's in the car, cause I have to play what they want to hear. And it's like so hard for me to just like, I don't know. So it's like, yeah, take the aux. So like, yeah, whatever's like the biggest at the moment, that's what we play, yeah. Probably one of my own songs to hype me up before a live performance, either that or just dead silence. I like just like silence and just like being alone before I go out on stage, cause I get really nervous before I go out on stage. But then when I go out on stage, I like don't get nervous anymore. It's just before I go on, I get super nervous. The song I can't stop listening to right now is this one song. It's called After Dark. It's by this guy, Mr. Kitty. And I found it because my girlfriend's sister was like playing it in the car, and I was like, you know, I have like a thing, like I'm embarrassed to ask what a song is, like if there's a lot of people in the car, because I'm like, either A, like, oh, I should probably know that, or like, B, like, oh, like, am I gonna look uncool if I ask what this is? So what I did, I like pulled out my phone, and I just started shazamming it while we were in the car, and I got it, and I went back home, and I haven't been able to stop listening to it for like the past week. So yeah, Mr. Kitty, After Dark, it's a great song. Well, I don't have a favorite song. I have like a whole joint, have a whole list I listen to, but one up top is like Floors and Sins by Juice WRLD. That's a great song, I love that song. My favorite song was, oh, I have albums of that. I have my own album about that. Jesus, I don't know, there's so many. I can't pick, but like anything off of my joint, anything off of my album that's called Love. Funny enough, yeah, anything off that, I'm putting that on. I'm gonna be honest, I don't do a lot of karaoke, but if I did do a lot of karaoke, it would be like a Drake song, like Shot For Me by Drake or something, or maybe a Kanye song. Like Blame Game by Kanye, that might be another one. I love that song. Every song that I listen to ever, I listen to it really loudly in the car. Like there's not even like, it's not even like, even just every song in general. Everyone looks at me like a psycho, like dude, your ears are gonna jump out of the drums. Cause I play my so loud, every song ever. Yeah. Without you. I might retire if I collaborate with Drake and Kanye, that you might never see me again. I'd probably move to like Cuba. Listen. Yo, what's up MTV? It's the Kid LAROI and I'm about to take you behind the gram. I'm on a boat in Mexico. I went to Mexico for New Year's with my girlfriend and my friend Han, and it was sick. We had a lot of fun. I released turtles onto the ocean. They're like little baby turtles, and we just like released them onto sand and whatnot. It's like probably one of the most fun trips I've ever had, ever. I would say fashion is super important to me. Ever since I was a kid, like I always was like trying to design my own clothes. I would like grab a piece of paper and like draw them and like draw it on. Like that's just something I've been super passionate about almost as long as I've been passionate about music. I'm definitely looking to start my own brand and stuff like that aside from the merch that I've already got out. Be on the lookout. What's happening there? Me and Justin had just finished playing like 5 games of basketball for the past couple of Sundays. We've been just going to his crib and playing basketball with all of his homies. He's one of the coolest dudes. Super nice and just welcoming. And I had looked up to him so much as a kid, and I always thought he was like the coolest kid ever. It's crazy to be able to hang with him and know him and call him my friend. I feel like I've like met so many artists and like collaborated with so many artists. I might retire if I collaborate with Drake and Kanye, that I might, you might never see me again. I'll probably move to like Cuba. Listen. Oh, I learned I really f*** with dogs, I guess. I love dogs. It's not my dog, it's Bibby's dog, but I'm getting a dog like that. Bibby, as well as being an incredible music manager and CEO, he actually breeds dogs. And he's gonna give me one, but that's his one. It's so funny, I know. Haha. It's me and my girlfriend. And I posted that photo for Valentine's Day. We went to the snow together at Mammoth. And I went skiing for the first time, which was sick. Skiing is probably one of my new favorite hobbies. I like thrill seeking, so I love jet skiing and all that type of. We met through a mutual friend and we've been dating for like 7 months now. So I'm in deep. And I think like the whole time that we've been dating, like the world has been like pretty closed. So like hasn't been a lot to do, but just eat and just like watch movies and. That's my favorite thing to do, just chill. Right there, was actually just a couple nights ago and I had like a little dinner with the label and shit, and I was like, why am I having a dinner with the label? This is weird. And we like rented off like the back section of Nobu and like they surprised me and bought me two of the plucks. What everyone says and do you, if you don't do it, somebody else is gonna do it, so. Don't miss out because you were scared of what people think. Bye, MTV. Because it was cool when Kanye did it, when I did it, it looked weird. Yo, what's up, MTV? It's the Kid LAROI, and today I will be answering questions based off of the titles of my songs.
Like I always do, 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 do.
My favorite thing to do in free time might not be TV friendly, so I'm gonna say I like to hang out with my friends.
I know that we ain't getting along, but I wanna see you on your own tonight.
Dating deal breakers? Like, this is just a personal thing, a personal preference. I'm not like hating on anybody. I don't think I could like date a girl who smokes cigarettes, not hating on anybody. I have like a weird thing with cigarettes, like they actually trigger me. So I think that's probably the only deal breaker. You just can't smoke cigarettes or like be a crackhead.
I'm sorry, but I'm scared to be alone.
How do I deal with heartbreak? I make music and do the things that I talk about in my music when I get heartbroken. I definitely turn to music to pick myself up when I'm sad.
So maybe I'm driving me crazy.
I don't know, like I don't look forward to a lot of things because like I don't like setting like expectations or having high expectations for I don't know, I'm just excited to keep making music, try and spend more time with my family, and hopefully go back to Australia for like a little bit.
My life been tragic, thank you for asking.
The single most embarrassing fashion trend I've ever tried. I don't know if this is like embarrassing because I thought it was cool at the time, because it was cool when Kanye did it, when I did it, it looked weird. The Yeezus album came out and he used to wear those long shirts and he looked f***ing sick in them. I tried it before and I actually have a picture of it somewhere when I was like 10 and I tried it and it looked like I was wearing a dress. It was hilarious. I couldn't pull it off like he did, but I like to experiment with different things. I go through phases with fashion and like, see right now I'm wearing like these crazy boots. I don't hope to try any fashion trend in the future because if I think of it, I'm trying it. Bye, MTV.